Aloha and welcome to the second semifinal of the ILH Boys Water Polo Tournament. I'm Sherry Smart, and with me tonight is Coach Mark Moretzky. How are you, Mark?
I'm doing well, Sherry. Good to see you again.
It's been 10 minutes.
But it's still good to see
you. And we are still coming to you live from the Waterhouse Pool on the campus of Punahou School on this Wednesday evening, November 1st, 2017. The first sprint is underway, so let's introduce the teams. That ball went off the wall, so they're going to...
I think they were figuring it out, and the ball will go to Iolani.
Yeah, so let me introduce the teams. Wearing the white caps, the Warriors of Kamehameha coming in with a 7-5 record. Their head coach is Randy Bart. And in the dark caps, the Raiders of Iolani with a 8-4 record. These two teams faced off most recently just last week in their rubber game. They had played each other twice. Well, they played each other three times in the regular season, and the third game came down to the buzzer. So it's a really evenly matched teams. Looks like it's going to be a really exciting game. And the winners of this game will take on Punahou for the title.
Winners of the first semifinal this afternoon.
There's a shot attempt by number 13 for the Warriors, Jay Corner, the junior. There's a big long pass to Ethan Lau. He's got that ball in hand and takes a shot.
Stop, but the rebound comes out to Kenny McKinley on the right side there.
And there's plenty of time. You hear goalkeeper Rensout saying, time, time. We have plenty of time. They've isolated Ethan Lau there at center. It's not normally where he positions himself, but he's got himself in there, and he earns a kick out. I'm trying to see, is that number 14?
Number 14, Kana'i Ho from Kamehameha will spend a little time in the exclusion area. But Iolani did a nice job of working the ball to the left side where they could get the ball into the center and no help coming.
Amos Jung with the goal.
And then again, attacking from that side of the pool. Jung again, who I think was the person who put the entry pass in.
Yeah, and there he is with that in a real quick shot. He, to me, is a key to the... is if you were going to ask me some of the keys to the game for Iolani's success, it is to get Jun in the offense, to get him confident in his perimeter shooting early in the game. That will change the way that Kamehameha has to play. He is a really strong outside shooter, and there are times when he defers to others, and I think as being a senior and with his skill, he needs to take those shots. So there's another attempt by number 13, Jake Horner.
And Jun again on the counterattack, I believe.
Yeah, that's Jun. He might go into Lau. Oh, he takes the shot. That's a good idea.
That was a good idea. Just
barely that skip. He was so close to the goal that he doesn't have to quite shoot quite as hard. But I do think that the key to their success is Jun getting in the offensive rhythm, getting in the zone early.
Yeah, I think, he creates a lot of opportunities on that left side in the counterattack, too. He's usually pretty alert.
There's a strong shot and a shot block with real determination there by Pentland. The attempt was on number 8, Bubs Kahana, the senior. He is one of the leading scorers on this team. Dylan Stegman with the regular foul there. Stegman, the junior from Kailua. We've got a turnover mid-court here.
I didn't see that one. I think it was, is there a number 10 in there? I don't know.
Yeah, James Pentland.
James Pentland, but I didn't see what he did, but it looked like the referee was indicating number 10.
There's a crashing back and a lot of help there. Number 12 for Kamehameha, Connor Higgins.
And again, Amos Jun helping back, and now the outlet pass comes out to
and Lau.
The lead. Lau, Ethan Lau with that goal.
So it looks like Iolani's going to put a hard counterattack on every single one of these turnovers. And Lau with a skip shot, not afraid there to shoot. And I do think that is a good idea to get the rest of the players. Kenny McKinley, the senior for Iolani number 3, draws a lot of defense to him. He's a center, a very strong center player, and they got to get the rest of the offense going. So I think that bodes well for Iolani to go up 2-0 here halfway through this first quarter.
Yeah, I think just execution-wise, that Kamehameha is still kind of stuck in a rut. They've brought the ball down the left side there and tried to attack from there, but really haven't been too successful. So we'll have to see what their next attempt brings.
Oh, that was Kenny McKinley looking for a little help there from maybe from the referee. I'm not sure. The ball, you know, he did have position, but kind of lost control of the ball.
Yeah, I think a great power move, just lost the ball and needed to finish.
Joe Hernandez, the goalkeeper for Kamehameha, having a very solid season. He's a junior and kept them in the game in all of these close games pretty nicely. We got a turnover here. Ball goes to Iolani, and there is Ethan Lau is up left again. And he takes a strong turn move. Ethan Lau is not a huge kid, but he's a very savvy player, and he's quick, and he thinks that's a shot block from the field, I believe. Was that a field block, or was that the goalie?
Yeah, I couldn't tell if that was blocked by the goal, got to the goal or not.
Either way, the field block was up.
It didn't make it either way.
All right. Higgins in the entry pass to number 15. That's Evan Gates, the center for the Warriors. He's a real tall kid with a long arm span, and he's been taking all the abuse there at center for the Warriors. Kamehameha is now set up with a double post, or actually they're a little off center here. They're going to try to balance out. Ethan Buck out to, there's some nice little tricky passing. Attempt by Jun.
Well, I think what happens with the counterattack gets stalled, taking a little bit of time to just sort of figure out the right shape and who's going where.
Yeah, they were running out of time there, so a perimeter shot is likely if they can't isolate there at center. Ball comes into Higgins. Higgins with the backhand. Ren Sowat, the goalie for the Raiders. He's looking at he's going to force that outlet pass. I think that is a good idea. Get Ethan Buck for number 7 for Iolani. He's got to get himself down there. He had a little advantage. He still kind of does. Amos Jung goes back to Ethan Lau. They're looking to isolate there. Set that ball in. That's a good idea.
Yeah, I think that's going to be the one that Kamehameha is going to have to solve, because a right-handed backhand by McKinley, if they're not stopping that, it's going to be a long day.
Yeah, McKinley's, that's a beautiful shot. I didn't realize how great of a shot that was. A dinger, corner. Yeah.
I mean, they're going to have to figure out how to either push him outside of that post or sag back off of the passer, which in that case, Ethan Lau.
And he was over on his strong side.
Yeah, it's going to be hard to get someone down to that right hand, and you've just got to bank on the poor angle and whatnot of a right-handed backhand off the two post. But
yeah,
I mean, he's going to squeeze it in like that every time.
Right, he is a real skilled player. He is the leading, leader on this team, has the one player on the squad that's been a varsity player since his freshman year. We have a tip called there, so Kamehameha is going to take a corner throw with a new 35-second shot clock. Well, there's only 12 seconds to go in this first quarter. Connor Higgins meant to throw that ball out to referee Brendan Shum, but he kind of tosses it at his feet.
Kind of threw it at him.
Yeah. Number 6, Amos Jung, excluded. You can hear the counting down. And at the end of 1, Iolani 3, Kamehameha 0.
So the unfortunate thing for Kamehameha there is with that shot right at the end of the period, blocked and repossessed by Iolani, means that they will, both teams will start at even numbers at the beginning of the second quarter.
Yeah, we're looking at some of the replays. Here's the cross pass. Amos with the catch and shoot. Get him started right off the bat, like we said. That's a key to the game for them. There's a shot by number 13 for the Warriors, Jake Horner.
Jack, I believe, Horner.
I think it's Jake.
Is it right? I'm reading here. They've got a mispick then.
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
That's all right. He's on the swim team with he swam with Sierra.
See, I was going to say my son's Jack. I see everything.
And I have a son, Jack, too.
Yeah, and I'm going to cross this out.
They also have number 8, Kathan Kahana. Of course, we know Kathan as Bubs. That shot goes a little high. We're looking at the replays. There's been a lot of offense, or at least attempts. And that was a beautiful entry pass there by Ethan Lau to the backhand.
Yeah, I think that right caught the defender in between, and neither putting pressure on, really good enough pressure on Lau, but wasn't able to come back and take the ball away from McKinley at center either. So,
yeah.
I mean, the distance to come back, if McKinley were left-handed, then he can come back a half stroke sooner to that outer left hand. Maybe that's one thing, but it's a whole nother stroke
when you're right-handed.
They're off the two post, and that's where that defender's got to make a decision where he wants to be.
All right, so the Raiders are lining up. They're chatting with each other. Doesn't look like they have any substitutions coming in yet.
Let me see, number 3, McKinley.
Oh, yeah.
And number 2, Dustin Carr.
Oh, so Dustin is in. He's a sophomore, class of 2020. We each have one of those.
We do.
2020 vision.
2020 vision. Man, I remember when that sounded like a silly graduating year.
Didn't it? Didn't it sound like it was far away?
2020.
It was not very far away.
Yeah, I remember the days when I couldn't believe that I was going to be 32 in the year 2000. Oh, I'll be 32 in the millennium.
Connor Kennedy in for the Raiders with the sprint. Jake Horner wins that. Jake. We mentioned Jake swims for Kamehameha Swim Club. Real strong swimmer on a record-breaking relay team. He's a very quick.
Shows you where my mind's been. I'm calling him Jack. Everybody ought to know Jake Horner. Jake Horner.
That's okay. Wow. Number 12 is Connor Higgins. We've got a couple Connors in, one on each squad right now. Connor Kennedy for the Warriors. Oh, there's a beautiful shot.
Yeah.
By Bubs.
Bubs Kahana. Sort of that three-quarters Kent Tekulve submariner style, if I may.
Well, plus he's got that. It's sort of a sidearm. Watch this sort of sidearm whip.
That comes around, and I think there was a little bit of a field block, but that
was going in anyway.
Yeah, that ball was going in. Here we go. Iolani going to try to attack the left side of the pool again, maybe.
Yeah, we got a 3-1 game. Oh, that pass got skipped. That ball skipped.
Yeah, tough pass to throw in to somebody trying to post up. Got to get that ball to stick, not skip.
Joe Hernandez with the outlet pass to Kaimi Medina. Kaimi is a senior. Off to his fellow senior, Bubs Kahana. Back to Kaimi. He tries to take that in.
Funky cold Medina.
Kason Nitahara back to Medina with the cross pass.
Oh, stretching. Stretching his frame.
That's right. Connor Kennedy with the shot. It goes off the goalkeeper's hand, so Kamehameha gets a new possession and a whole new shot clock, 35 seconds. You got 5 and a half minutes and change to go in this second period of this second semifinal of the ILH Boys Championships. Nitahara off to Kahana. Bubs Kahana goes turning in there. We're going to have an ejection on somebody. Number 9, that's Connor Kennedy. He'll take his exclusion, and Coach Randy Bart will call a timeout. Kennedy on the exclusion. We got a 3-1 game. Iolani over Kamehameha. This this is a big possession here, a big difference between a 3-2, coming in the rest of this quarter with a 3-2 score, or if Iolani makes a big stop here, that will boost their confidence level for sure.
Yeah, I think Randy Bart knows how serious this is as he pulls the Warriors over to the side and try to figure out, hey, how do we score this 6-on-5, and then let's make sure that we play a real solid defensive possession or stand. We put on a real solid defensive stand coming up after that, too. You'd like to score and keep a little momentum.
Yeah, especially after they just had a turnover down. They earned a turnover. Yep. On their last defensive possession, and then come right down on offense and earn a kickout. Momentum has switched to their side. They need to convert on this.
A little pep talk.
Yeah. Take a little break. They'll go get themselves set up into position. The referee's blowing his little whistle saying, come on now.
They may have taken advantage of the gutter there, getting a little echo out of that cheer. Always important.
All right. So I don't believe they have any lefties in the pool right now, the Warriors. So they'll still set up in a 4-2, likely. Set up in a 4-2, or maybe start in a 3-3 and move to a 4-2. Let's see what they do. Yeah, they're kind of sort of driving in that player.
There we go.
All right. So you can see the excluded player for Iolani. That's actually Dylan Stegman taking the spot of Connor Kennedy, who was ejected. Kaysen Nitahara to Connor Higgins to Bubs.
And Iolani's sixth defender is back in, and this ball.
That is it.
Stolen.
Pentland comes up with that. There's a bunch of players out of the goal. The goal was wide open. Rensawit had come on out to try to steal it. Didn't quite finish that, but he got some help from his teammate.
I was going to say.
McKinley dishes that out, and rightfully so. That's a regular foul here.
That
there's
pass
still
from, the perimeter, trying to go all the way into McKinley, is what really killed that attack there. It's just much too far.
Yeah, too long. And there's McKinley with a beautiful move.
Yeah, he had a defender for Kamehameha, Kanaiho, come back, but rather than going to the ball to take it out of McKinley's hand, he just comes center.
Look at his leg strength here, though. He gets around, then he goes up, stays up, takes a hard fake, goes right side. Yeah, McKinley with that earned. He's looking to play next year in college somewhere. I think he has a good chance of making somebody's roster. Not sure where he's looking yet, but he does intend to look for a match for him, a school where he can play some water polo. So we have a 4-1 game. Iolani over Kamehameha.
Ooh, tickling the twine.
Yeah, Kaysen Nitahara, he was trying to look away.
Yeah, he probably next time out of luck. What? All right. No, I think that was a hard one there to squeeze in.
Yeah, now if that had gone in, we would be saying, ooh, nice. There's McKinley again. Oh, with the easy, tries to go up and over.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know that he knew how open he was there. He actually held on. Had a lot of time. Same Kanaiho sort of watching. Had a great seat there behind, and instead of taking the ball out of McKinley's hand, let McKinley have another little scissors kick and try to score that.
But Joe Hernandez, the goalkeeper, gets his finger on it. The ball goes out of bounds, so that's why Iolani retains possession. They've got a freshman in the pool right now. The Raiders do. Andrew Dawson. And this is Amos Jun with 23 seconds to go in the shot clock. He's going to feed that in. Oh, double.
Wasn't the best attack I've seen from the Raiders.
I think they were trying to get a little tricky there.
Well, I really thought the perimeter foul that gave Jun the chance both for the pass and the direct shot was a mistake, but he didn't get them to pay. Didn't exact the price.
Yeah, I think he looked at the clock and knew there's 23 seconds. Maybe too much time on the clock to take the direct. However, like we said earlier, we want him to he needs to establish himself as a perimeter shooter.
Yeah.
And that will help his team create more offense at center.
So we have the ball coming out here. To be honest, folks, I'm not sure what we've pulled the ball out
for. Yeah, I think he was finishing tying his cap, maybe.
Got it.
It was half on.
We've got caps tied and a warrior attack to begin again.
Kasen Mitsuhara with the ball there. The sophomore goes back to the sophomore. His sister played on the squad for four years of high school. There's an attempt. Pass. Oh, wow. There's a lot of scrambling going on there. Connor Higgins almost gets the rebound.
Yeah, that was.
And now Ilani going hard on their counterattack.
One of those where you just put your hand underneath it and flip it in. But the tendency is to want to grab it on top and throw it or push it.
Lau's going to set that into McKinley. Oh, that is a strong. Okay, I got to give credit to Ethan Lau on that entry pass there. He got up big as if to attempt to shot, the direct shot. Here comes the, he looks at it, and then he soft pass right into the hand of McKinley. And McKinley, like Ethan Walter from Punahou, both really able to score with their whole body underwater, head and all, able to put that one away.
Well, two things. One, I think wherever McKinley goes, he ought to take Jun and Lau with him, because those two guys are great at getting him the ball. And the one thing that I see a little more from McKinley than I see from Ethan Walters is some lateral movement. Whereas Ethan tends to be pretty vertical and in one place and not stepping certainly across the face of the goal as much as I see McKinley doing.
Yeah, and yeah. McKinley's longer. You know, he's got a
different body type.
Different body type.
Yeah.
And Ethan Walter, for his stature, he's so quick. They're both quick.
A little bit more power, I think, at times from Ethan. And McKinley a little more mobile and kind of using a little bit more of his length. And I don't know if you could put the cameras on me. You can see me kind of moving around in the chair here. He moves around in his chair kind of like
does,
I'm doing
he
right
does.
Now.
Yeah. Well, and both of them will make somebody happy on their roster next year as collegiate players.
I think both of them, you can see maybe a year or two of just getting a lot of reps and a consistency of having to beat defenders who are a little more savvy, a little stronger, and so forth. But both of them understand the game and have a really good sense, and you think could make that transition, I think, well.
Yeah, and they're good students. They'll do fine. I do think they'll be able to play. Coach Ian Kusau for the Raiders doing a good job with some early substitutions in both these last two quarters. He's had Dustin Carr's been in, Connor Kennedy's been in, Andrew Dawson gets some minutes, giving his starting group a little rest here and there. I think that's a real smart move on his part.
Yeah, I think important, right? It's you know that the last game came down, as you said, literally to the last second.
It did. See that shot? That Bubs Kahana is a very quick.
Well, that was Nitahara.
Oh, that was Nitahara.
Yeah, he's now coming up with that.
He looks like his friend, yeah.
He's dropping down with that right arm.
Skippy thing. Those are dangerous shots. Those often skim in like a stone, like you're skipping a stone at a lake.
Yeah.
Ethan Lau with the entry pass. It's a little too crowded there.
Yeah, and unfortunately, of course, just as I was saying, Ethan Lau and
Amos Jun.
And Amos Jun feed the ball in, but that one way up high off the water. McKinley's got to knock it down, and by then a second defender's there taking the ball away.
And the Warriors doing what they needed to do on that, bringing that second defender. There's Kasen Mitsuhara off to Jake Corner. Jake into center. Bad pass there. Pentland comes up with it.
Yeah, just going with kind of flipping the ball in, and boy, those kind of passes are not gonna make it. You've got a small window of space and time. Got to pinch it in there. We've got this game's master here. Amos Jun has been showing us. There we go.
Right on target.
Now he comes with a quick release. Doing number six proud.
Oh, hey. Okay.
Jun.
Yeah, I actually really like the way he plays, and he did not have a good game. He would tell you he did not have a good game. The last time these two matched up, it seemed like his energy level or his confidence level was down.
Well.
And I think it means a lot to this team when he's playing well, getting in a little bit of a zone.
Josiah Hernandez, meet Jun.
Yeah.
Sorry, I had to. Meet Jun. Anyway.
Meet Jun. Okay, yeah. Never right, mind. I'll never mind. Jun. That's a local joke.
All right.
Or I don't know. Yeah.
Funny kind.
Funny kind.
Come on.
Jay Corner
kind.
To Connor
Hernandez,
Higgins.
Meet Jun. All right. I'll try that like a third time.
Okay. We'll get it. We'll laugh sometime soon.
Okay. Oh man.
Would you like some cow bee with that? Oh. That's a Bob's Kahana is just fun to watch, though. He just doesn't mind picking that up and firing away.
Gunning
just,
it. Well, yeah. that's how
oh,
you
there's
get
a
nickname
nice move.
Like Bubs.
That's right.
Yeah.
Kennedy earns the kick out. Oh, no. Connor Kennedy earns the kick out there. 6 seconds on the clock. Try to decide if they should shoot that. We got a rebound.
Flip
he should flip that
there.
Off to his
yeah.
teammate.
I was going to say we had
I don't believe.
Dylan Stegman sitting there for a second all open.
So I think they decided to hold on to it. Maybe they'll use the timeout after this sprint. So this is halftime here. We've got
6-1,
a
I believe.
6-1 game.
Raiders. They'll this time really putting it to the Warriors, huh?
Yeah, they had all Raiders have all the momentum going their way right now. And there's Bubs with this shot. He doesn't mind firing. There's his goal right there with the big skip or skimmer. I like to call those a skimmer.
Yeah, I think, obviously it's easy to say. I was going to start out with the incredible bit of wisdom and say, really, they've only been successful attacking from the top. But that's easy to say when a team only has one goal.
Yeah,
they've really though been pretty stuck. Haven't had much of a center presence and been forced to shoot from the outside. And yeah, and that's where I come up with that jewel. Successful
with their one. Yeah,
the
with
perimeter.
Their one shot.
Yeah,
and if that shot attempt right there with by Bubs Kahana right there at the end of the quarter, very similar to his first goal that did go in. So he feels like it's maybe available again to him. Now, these teams have played lopsided games in halves before, and the other team comes back, or this is a five-point spread, which is a little unusual for them. They're often much, much tighter. But having said that, I believe Yolani was up 3 goals, I believe, in a game up at Kamehameha a month ago or so, and Kamehameha came back and tied it and then won the game in overtime. So I'm pretty sure Randy Bart there that we're seeing chat with his team, telling him it's four quarters, gang.
We're not out of it.
Got to play four quarters.
Yeah. Yeah. I think if you're Yolani, you're hoping to come out and score, you know, the first
early.
Goal, score early and,
yeah.
and sort of, you know, step on the fingers holding on to the cliff.
Yeah, neither team has been playing. Neither team has been playing power play. We don't have a lot of ejections on either side, so there's nothing. You know, those are oftentimes that's one way to get yourself back into it. Try to earn some ejections. You control the ball longer. You have more time of possession with the ball. But the way the game's flowing doesn't seem like there's been a lot of kickouts. However, right there at the end of the game, at the end of the half. Connor Kennedy drew an ejection on when he took that inside move and took a couple strong strokes. The player came over his back, and I believe there's still time on that ejection.
Yeah, I think they've probably got 12
seconds
left
yeah.
on it, maybe less.
So if Yolani wins the sprint, they could choose to call a timeout so that they could go set up their 6-on-5. If Kamehameha wins the sprint, then the player will come even.
Yeah, we'll see. I think I can't remember who won both sprints, whether it was Kamehameha.
Well, the very first one there was the ball hit out of bounds, and so
went to Yolani, right?
Went
yeah.
to Yolani. It was Jay Corner that won the sprint, but he clipped it with his wrist and it hit the out of bounds. So Yelani gets that one, and then the second one, Kamehameha won again. So I think they're looking to Jake Horner to do that for them. But, you know, they're on the other side. Maybe the wind is picking up.
Or the current, right?
Yeah.
You don't know. And
the swell.
I've always thought that there was a little bit of a current in this pool, and I know that sounds silly, but I don't know.
I think you could be right.
I mean, there are some pools that, I swear there's one direction that feels a little easier.
I think you're right. And there's, if not, at least your head thinks so. And then, you know, when you're...
That's all that matters.
That is all that matters. If you think so...
If you think it's true.
Yeah, that's it. Right. So you can see in the background some of the Punahou players are all dressed and ready to go home. They might be watching the rest of this game before they head out, because they will be playing the winner of this game, having won the previous game, the game played just before this. And then the Owls of Mid-Pacific will play the loser of this game, and they will take on each other for third place on Friday evening, 5 p.m.
We'll be back.
Right
here. Broadcasting a doubleheader.
Yeah, well, hopefully we'll have another nice sunset. It's dark out now, but there's still not hardly a breath of wind.
No, there isn't.
It's pretty muggy.
I was going to say this weekend is the last weekend here at Punahou for Wonderful Town musical.
That's right. I heard that's real good.
It's going on at Dillingham Hall. Yeah, I think Friday night at 7:30 and the last show, the 4th. Of November, Saturday night, also at 7:30. So if you're on island and interested in coming by to see some of the talent on stage, come see Wonderful Town.
That's right. You could come and watch a water polo game on Friday night and then go and see the play on Saturday night.
You might. You probably don't want to try to squeeze in water polo
on Friday.
At 6:15.
Yeah, 7:30.
Yeah,
it's
tight. That's probably not the best idea. That'd be the kind of thing I would do, and then I'd be late.
Late to something.
Messing it up, yeah. That's usually the MO there.
So we've got Jay Corner for Kamehameha sprinting against, I believe that's Amos Jun. No, let's see. I can't tell. His head's down. And Jake wins the sprint, so Kamehameha will come even.
Well, and that's obviously the benefit of having a strong swim program and strong swimmers on your team.
And then he comes right back with the goal. So that's a sprint play.
Yeah.
Somehow he got open on the sprint. Usually the trailer, let's see. I don't know if they can show us.
That's another one of those. It's similar to what Puno did in the first quarter against Mid-Pacific, but just didn't, somehow Yelani didn't pick people up off the sprint. And
Yeah, it's normally the trailer, the second person in line, is responsible for picking up the sprinter.
Didn't communicate well, yeah. And then, and you know, 6-2, all right, that's only a 4-goal difference, but now you got to work again, right?
We were talking about momentum, and this game is a game of momentum, and especially with the teams being so evenly matched as they are, they know that they can get back into it. They know they've played already 12 quarters, well, now 14 quarters of water polo against each other, and the spread is just basically, it's 1 point towards, game. So they're going to just keep hammering away. And this is a big stop for Yelani and equally
that
big.
A great idea, I thought.
I did too. Kaimi Medina with the kind of the backhand post and just misses wide.
Had his hand up for a while, and I kept waiting for James Pentland to come around inside. Never made it back there, but just didn't get the right shot off.
So Pentland goes out to Lau. Lau with the entry pass to Pentland on the drive, and there's been a crash back.
Yeah, some good help there from Kanaiho. And Kamehameha takes the ball, and again, it just sort of a little momentum.
Yeah, ball control at this point is a real important part of this game. You know, managing the clock, managing your possessions, your time with the clock.
Yeah.
Your time with the ball. Kanaiho takes a big swing. And Ren Sao just picks that one right up. And out to Lau. He's got a slight advantage there. He's gonna got the ball in hand with the skip shot. He's trying to pump up his fans and his friends. Ethan Lau, the junior, watch this shot. He's about 5'6 and 120 pounds, maybe. I don't know, maybe 130. And he just, he's like,
soaking
come on,
wet.
Man.
Yeah. I mean, I'm one to talk here.
Yeah, I know, me too, but yeah. Still. he really is trying to pump up his squad here and get that right back. That was a big goal for Iolani because the momentum had shifted towards the Warriors of Kamehameha.
Yeah, it's kind of that period of the game where you're waiting to see, well, even at a score of 7-2, all right, which team is going to grab the momentum?
That's
here?
Right. Yeah, it's Evan Gates with the shot. We haven't seen him much. He takes that shot to the right side. Ren Sowett makes a good stuff block, and the Warriors will get a new 35. Ren Sowett's a story there, the senior goalkeeper for the Raiders. He started his career as an intermediate player in ninth grade.
Oh,
holy
wow.
Smokes.
From the side.
Is that Kaisa Nitahara? Kaysen?
Nitahara again
Nitahara.
With that. He drops that elbow down and
very deceptive.
Yeah, he's able to kind of sneak one by every time. That's a nice little deceptive shot. Sorry, I'm glad I'd get more information up here on the screen.
Yeah.
And it's taking me forever.
All right, well, figure it out. Figure it out. So there's been a big pickup in energy in both teams this third quarter here. Comes out strong, Nitahara with that goal from out at the wall. I mean, really, it was super deceptive. I think I was just about to tell the story about Ren Sowett.
Sorry, but yeah, poor Sowett has to endure.
He's going to go weak there. There it is. It's pass is available, and that's shot.
Oh, we had a perfect angle there.
That's right. That was a cut. He covered the cage, Ren. This is, oh, and there's a bad pass. That ball just skipped. That's really, when you got all this energy, you know, as a goalie, sometimes you have to put a little light touch on that pass so that it doesn't skip away from you. But that's hard to do.
Yeah, harder from the goal, and you're throwing so long, and that angle is sharp.
Yeah, you got to put a little rainbow on it, but it's...
A little bit of sticky on the water.
Yeah, but that is one of the things. Both of these goalies are actually really good passers, and that is one of their strengths. So it's rare to have a bad pass like that. He's trying to earn a kick out there.
Yeah, I'm
field
not sure
block.
What he was doing there. That was the put my head underwater, dribble it on the surface, and.
Got a timeout called by Coach Ian Kusau. Probably with just about halfway through this third quarter, he's. Going to give his team a little break, have them settle down a little bit, and I think that's a good idea. It was the intensity was ratcheted up about 100% compared to the end of that second quarter, so both teams coming out really hard, charging away, and it's a good time out there to let the team settle down.
I thought it was starting to feel a little frenetic, and it was a nice decision by Kusau to call a timeout and just try to settle his team. Of course, I'm sure Coach Randy Bart for Kamehameha wants to do the same, but yeah, just to, you know, you had that feel of momentum being traded back and forth, and then a little bit of
It was frantic.
That
you do have to settle down. They have plenty of timeouts. Each team gets three regular and one what we call the 20, which is basically a substitution timeout. So
that's
here, halfway through the third quarter, we have a 7-3 game. Iolani over Kamehameha, and at Iolani's possession right now. But they're coming out of the timeout. They'll have 34 seconds to run their attack.
Not sure what kind of advice Kusau might have right now, but
Let's
see if we can read some lips there. No, I don't know.
I'm not sure either, but he's not drawing up a specific play, and I don't think he really needs to. It's not like that type of a timeout. I think it's a timeout where he's just going to settle down, maybe do a little subbing, maybe not, but just sort of, like you said, the frenetic, the kind of the frantic pace was not favoring actually either team. They were not playing, you know, it was just a little frantic.
Well, I'd like to tell your team also, hey, look, we've got essentially 3 minutes left. It's 2:58, you know, we're left in the third. We're each going to have two or three possessions.
Yeah,
let's be really safe with the ball. Let's get out of this quarter. We don't need any more goals.
Right.
We just want to prevent them from scoring. So a really deliberate attack that takes the whole shot clock. And
yeah,
they should have two or three possessions and limit Kamehameha to two.
Yeah, that ball control we were talking about. You know, if you shoot early, you give the other team more chances.
Yeah. Yeah, really a game of numbers at this point, and then you can get it down into the fourth quarter and steal a couple possessions and then get out of the game, I think, and make it to Friday.
Yeah, there's a turn move. I think Coach Ian Kusau was looking for an ejection there on that turn move. When you make a deliberate move like that and then get fouled from behind, oftentimes you can earn a kick out on that exclusion because of a positioning foul.
Yeah, personally, I thought that whistle killed the attack there. I mean, it was a little too far out. The direct shot he ended up taking should have been turned over. It took too long for it.
Yeah.
And really, at that point, just no reason for a whistle.
Let
that
play.
Attacker decide what he's going to do to go forward again.
Connor Higgins with the drive in.
Good help from
Amos Jun.
Amos Jun.
And Iolani on the attack. They've got a 3-on-1 right now.
Except unfortunately, Jun's pass skips forward, but I think they're going to make it out of it.
Oh, Stegman.
And I was wrong. Josiah Hernandez shutting that one down. And again, you don't possess for a long time.
And then
the nice thing is Kamehameha gives it right back. So here you've got a minute and 43 seconds. You'd like to be able to say, look, we can take a lot of time off of the clock.
Oh, look at that hand.
But what do I know?
And
throw
another
it into McKinley, let's get a goal.
Yeah, and a Lau to McKinley connection there. Again, Ethan Lau with a perfect pass in. That's an inch closer to the goalie. He's coming out for that. And then the patience by Kenny McKinley with the wrist action. Players on his back.
Yeah, that was nice. Yeah. Probably not what you draw.
No, you can't make that. You can't draw that one up.
No, you don't draw that up. But when you've got some players who have, and again, between Jun and Lau, the two of them with McKinley seem to have a real good connection.
I agree. That ball just a little high. That entry pass just a little high.
Yeah.
You've got a little bit of an advantage here, not quite. He goes, yeah, all right, so.
Here comes McKinley, center cage.
McKinley, with his rare opportunity to shoot from the perimeter, he's going to take advantage of that. And looks like Kamehameha is going to call a timeout here. McKinley's like, okay, I get to shoot from the perimeter, thanks. And he just hits that corner.
Yeah, 56 seconds. That's funny. I seem to remember. I think we've had about four possessions by each team since.
Right.
It
we
was
said there was
going to
be three total.
Talking about being deliberate and hey, right. Let's get out of the quarter. No. Let's go up and down.
Yeah. What do we know?
Run and gun. Let's go Paul Westhead Lakers style.
Yeah, we don't know anything. What are we talking about? So we've got Kenny McKinley with 5 goals already, and there's still time left in the third. And he has basically scored from every spot.
Ethan Lau
and Ethan Lau,
Amos Jun
with the others.
Goals.
And Ethan's been getting points on the assists.
Yeah.
Left and right.
That threesome there has been, at least in terms of the attack, a real solid threesome, I think.
Yeah. Dylan Stegman had his opportunity on that 3-on-1. The pass took just a little too long to get to him. He's right-handed.
Yeah.
He either needs to set himself, his chest and hips towards the goal so he can catch it cross-face and swing around, or just do the backhand tip.
Yeah, just redirect that.
Yeah, the redirect. But the ball kind of took a while to get to him, and he also was leery about how close to get, because he can't get in front of the ball and be inside the 2 meters, then he's offside. So
that's where he's just got to park, I think, like
park
you were
himself,
saying.
Yeah.
Park,
drop the hips, get the hand
square
up.
Square your hips to the ball, get your right shoulder in goal side and get ready to redirect one in there.
Yeah, they, that pressure though to score on those when you're, you know, it looks really obvious, like this should be an obvious goal, that makes it all the harder to do.
Yeah, very true.
So Kamehameha's coming out of the timeout. Joe Hernandez will start with the ball. He tosses it out with tight pressure on that number three, Kaysen Nitahara. But number seven for the Warriors, Kainoa Andrade, he looks in and feeds that ball in. There's a backhand attempt by number 11, Kaimi Medina.
Was chuckling again. We were at 46 seconds.
And we're still going to get
shot.
Another.
I think Kamehameha was trying for the two for one. Oh. And Iolani's giving it right back.
So there's going to have, and there's still plenty of time, actually. 20
yeah.
seconds from now, they still have lots of time.
Ball outlet to the left, but
slightly mishandled.
Yeah.
There is an open player right here, number seven, Kainoa Andrade. He passes it out to his teammate.
There we go, Nitahara. Kaysen Nitahara with that
deadly
three-quarter right hand, right arm.
Let's see how his arm skims low. He must have played baseball.
Yeah, doesn't it? Yeah, he's dropping down off the mound there.
Oof,
pyrotechnics wow. coming off of that scoreboard.
That's
that.
Right. So with the sophomore for the Warriors with a clutch and the ball, the last attempt shot. Okay, so we said that we said that there would be like three possessions each. There was probably about six.
17
yeah.
for each team, I think, with averaging 6.3 seconds of possession and two shots for every attack.
There's Jay Corner with the redirect, or passing the pass to number 11, Kaimi Medina. And then the attempt by Kanaiho. And here we have Lau
wow.
with the just ball in hand. He's kind of swimming with it and just takes really a forearm shot. That's Evans Gates with that. Evan Gates with that
Snap
one.
With a nice block. Here we got.
Oh, that was close.
One more time with Kanai Ho.
And Amos Jun with the attempt after
that. Yeah. I may be wrong. I was going to say, and that was the one that gave Kamehameha the ball back, but I don't think
it did on that one. But there's McKinley with two in a row right here. His perimeter shot and his that second to last one that we just saw was really his best shot of the night, I think. And then
Kaysen. Final goal by Nitahara. So the Raiders break huddle at the start of the fourth with a five-goal lead.
Five-goal lead.
Five goals. So we went into the third at 6-1. So they hold on to that five-goal lead, riding the roller coaster a little bit. But
yeah.
Here we go. On average, I think we'll see 23 possessions.
All right, so what's the score right now?
The score, what did I say the
you
score
said it was?
9-4.
9-4.
That
makes sense. Yeah, we've got two on the Warriors side, two goals from Kaysen Nitahara, the sophomore, one from Bubs Kahana, the senior, and one from Jay Corner, the junior. And on the Iolani side, five from Kenny McKinley, number three, a couple from Ethan Lau, and a couple from Amos Jun. And Ethan Lau and Amos both get credit, I think, especially tonight for their entry passes or their assists.
Yeah, doing a nice job of feeding McKinley.
Yeah, and both goalkeepers are doing a great job. That's where one of the reasons that these two teams have been so even all along is that they're, you know, individually, they're man for man, they're pretty darn close. And they have had a very exciting season. So the very first time they met up in September was they played at Iolani, and Iolani prevailed. And then they had an overtime win up at Kamehameha, had an overtime win up at Kamehameha. And then this third game was just last week. They went into that game. Oh, so,
sorry.
Yeah, so.
So they've held
look
home
like,
court.
Yeah, they, that's it. So that's what earned Iolani that second seed. Amos Jun takes that perimeter foul and then crosses it. Dylan Stegman into the Pentland at the post. Well, he was out a little bit outside the post.
Can't put that ball down there.
So number five for the Warriors, Strider Garrett. Somehow loses that. And again, ball control makes a big difference here.
Yep.
Ethan Buck.
Let's see.
He's looking there. He sees his teammate, fellow junior, fellow Ethan. Ethan. And Lau with his third. It's a nice assist from Ethan Buck. Here goes Buck number seven. He sees his player, puts it on the water there. Notice how Ethan Lau takes a look behind him. And that's his signature shot there, bottom right, and then the fist pump.
Always a fist
but
pump.
But that little skip bottom right, that's his go-to, and I think he's 3 for 3 on those. Oh, no diving in. He's telling them don't dive in. I think they're a little bit confused. What is he saying?
Is that a new...
Some rule about not diving in. Most pools, some pools are shallower. This is pretty an all-deep pool. But the rule's the rule, and they're not supposed to go head first. There's Kaysen. No. Mitahara feeling emboldened.
Why not? Shoot it 4 seconds into your possession.
Oh, that's a great spot there. Ethan Buck with the attempt.
All right, and that one, we're averaging probably now about 7 seconds of possession. Here we go.
But both teams still swimming really hard. Considering we still have 5 minutes to go in this fourth quarter, I'm surprised at the level of intensity. Well, maybe I'm not surprised. I'm really not.
Yeah.
I do think that the team who controls themselves and the ball the longest this quarter is going to come out with a slight advantage. Ethan Buck with
an exclusion. Yeah. Ethan Buck excluded.
That's number seven for the Raiders. He'll sit out for 20 seconds. The Warriors on the there you go. That's dangerous.
Yeah, it was a nice little sequence, passing sequence.
The passing is what did it for them on that one.
Yeah, I think you just saw Iolani defenders getting sucked out toward the ball, and you can see there, 10,
yep,
there goes Pentland, James
and then
Pentland
Kainoa
comes out. And yeah.
Andrade with that low skip. That's a great movement.
Open. Yeah, that ball movement there was good. And
those dry passes makes the defense move. It's hard to keep, to makes the goalie have to cover more. So good execution by the Warriors on that 6-on-5, and they score. And Kenny McKinley, he's still got the ball and goes for the little left-handed lob. His teammate James Pentland was screaming from behind. I don't see any way that he could have even seen him there. He might have just heard him and tossed it, but I don't know if that would have been. It's not really Kenny's style to just throw blindly.
Yeah.
There's Kaysen. All right, so Ren Sawit knew that that was going to be a skip. Did you see how he cupped that? He put both forearms on the water down at the. Oh, that's the second. Okay. We call the ducking under. That is a legitimate. There's a good pass. Yeah. Goal by McKinley with an assist from Buck. And Buck was looking to shoot that, and instead, watch him. He takes a look, and he pumps it. Then he goes, oh, never mind. I'm going right here to my teammate, my senior leader. And half the cage was open.
Somebody else giving McKinley the ball. Nice.
And McKinley gets to shoot from somewhere else, too.
Yeah.
That's his about shooting from the one spot.
Left side of the pool. Still attacking from the left side there.
All right, number three, Kaysen. So what I was going to say is Kaysen took that shot earlier. Oh, there's a full-on pressure from the Raiders. Kaima Medina had no chance. There was players all over. He was surrounded. I hear some people saying patience. And I do think that that's what we were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
And there's another turnover. So the turnovers occur most likely in center. And if
that pass is
even slightly off,
yeah,
just slightly
really
errant,
perfect.
Then you're going to lose it. And if you want to have patience, if you want to use the whole clock and not be swimming back and forth, these guys are on their, I don't know how many thousands of yards they've swum this game. Yeah, that's a kick out. Number six. Oh, I thought that was number 10, Pentland, on the ejection, but that'll be Amos Jun's second. He got one early.
Hmm. Yeah.
I thought I saw Pentland's shoulders, but maybe not.
We're in a different
place.
Here's
Bubs with the skip shot. Oh. That is his favorite spot in the pool to shoot from, and he is highly successful there, but that one goes high. Now Coach Ian Cousseau is telling him swim because they're going to earn it. And it a transitional ejection, Bubs Kahana, so he's holding two hands, I guess. Timeout, Iolani. That's a full timeout, regular timeout. They do have a power play in their future.
Well, so with 2 minutes and 14 seconds left, I'd say we have time for seven possessions per team.
Right.
Let's see if we can get three or four shots.
Yeah, it more. Should be about. There we go. What did you do? We're back. There was a little mix-up with the Pro Mix 4.
That must have been me. I must have
you
done that.
You looked at it weird.
I did. I looked at it funny.
No,
see,
I don't
Coach?
Know. All right. So, like we said, with 2 minutes and 14 seconds to go in this fourth period.
Let's see.
You will be telling your team, okay, we get two possessions each. Course, that's not really the way that this game's been going.
Yeah, no, I think we've got probably 3.5 for Iolani left and
five,
4 for
yeah, yeah.
4 or 5 for Kamehameha.
We'll see, but we've got 11.
Let's try to take a little time off the clock.
Five, yeah. All right, so Kamehameha is going to start pulling some players out of the offense, or the defense, actually, and for this exact reason, to try to get the ball back right away.
They're still at 2:02,
right?
2 minutes left.
So there was only, we got the two-minute warning here.
2 minutes left in the game.
That's Jake Horner, I believe, with a beautiful move.
Yeah, well, there you go.
Okay, that was all muscle, all strength.
147.
Right.
One
so we've had
each.
One possession each, and we're only 16 seconds or something. I don't know.
So here we go. Second for Iolani.
So there he goes. Takes a swim. Look, watch. He swims in with the ball, and he swims another stroke. Meanwhile, he doesn't let go of the ball so that he can – if he lets go of the ball there, he might, you know, get a foul, but then it's just a regular foul. He wants to own that. This is going to be dangerous for Kamehameha. Yeah, we got a kick out.
Exclusion for Kamehameha, 6-on-5. Power play for the Raiders, and we need to remove the excluded player, make sure he knows he's excluded, get him out of the game, stop the clock so that we can organize things.
Right, so the reason that there was an exclusion there, well, mostly, is because Kenny McKinley was at center with a player. Look at Ethan Buck with a skip shot.
1:17 left in the game.
There is still so much time for action in this game.
Yep. So now
watch this. One fake, two fake, three fake, and then he goes right slow. Good shot. He needs to get a little bit more off of his back. He's leaning a little bit far back. It limits his range and his range of motion with that body position. So Ethan Buck, when you watch this on the replay, Coach Sherry is telling you get your legs under you a little bit.
Legs are important.
Yeah, just he's leaning back a little too much. That the opportunity or the likelihood of shooting high and hitting the high bar goes up when you're that close to the goal. Look at, we've got another we have another ejection.
Another exclusion. Here we go.
I'm not sure what number 10, Pentland's out. Good passing. This is what made success there. Oh. Jay Corner with the garbage goal. That's his third and two in a row. And like we said, there is a lot of action. That's Jay Corner's third goal. And if we count Ethan Buck's earlier, we have one, six. I believe it's 12 to six, seven.
12 to seven.
12 to seven.
We're still at our five-goal difference.
That's right. I'm not counting.
I think we're looking
right
at three possessions for each team since 2:12 left in the quarter. And we've still got 22 seconds.
We do. At last quarter when there was 22 seconds.
There
each team.
We got a shot. So there we go. Fourth possession for Iolani. No. Repossessed for Kamehameha. We may get out of the quarter here, Sherry.
We might.
14 seconds, though. A lot can happen.
And there's Kaysen Nitahara with it. He's going to his teammate. And remember what happened last time. They gave him the corner throw. He scored from way the heck out there.
That's right.
And
that's
Horner. Right.
And there he goes.
With that
skip.
How does he do that? That is incredible, that shot angle. I hope we get to see that again. That's his fourth three in this quarter alone.
Well, if we see it again, it'll come from replay man Hunter Nishikawa. His director
good.
Is Andrew Perez, and our three camera operators are Malia Margulies, Keely Thompson, and Braden Bella. Thanks so much, all of you, for an awesome job tonight.
What a great, yes, thank you. And what a great game for these two teams. Congratulations to the Raiders of Iolani. They will be playing for the ILH title on Friday, November 3rd. At 6:15 right here at Punahou, against Punahou School. And the Warriors of Kamehameha will take on the Owls of Mid-Pacific for third at 5 o'clock. Look at that great passing there. We're seeing some of the highlights of this last quarter. Nitahara.
Yeah, that was a
that's his
nice
same. That's his shot.
Play there by Sayat.
Yeah, and there we got the pass to McKinley from Buck. And Bubs with the just too much on that, his just too much of a wrist spin, and then Jay Corner with the all by himself here earns that one with the soft lob. And Ethan Buck, one fake, two fakes, three fakes, low skip. Good job, just great idea there. Jay Corner gets the garbage on that one too. So you can see the two teams shaking hands. It was a great season matchup for these two. It's 2017, I think they should be proud of the way they played against each other the whole season.
Yeah. Well, we'll come down to game for all of the teams.
That's right. So why don't you tell us again what's happening on Friday, and we'll sign off.
So Friday, join us at 5 p.m. We'll have Kamehameha playing Mid-Pacific for third place in the ILH. And then at 6:15, the championship match between the Punahou Buff and Blue, the Iolani Raiders in their fourth matchup for the year.
That's
and
it.
And we'll play four quarters to see who comes out atop the ILH.
I hope to see you all there. Join us if you can.
We'll be there. Thanks so much,
Thank
Sherry.
You, Mark.
And thanks, students.
Yes, you guys did a great job. Aloha.
Good night.